over on the side of Spacious in a newer roster, but consistency has been key for them at this event, so we'll see if that holds through and allows them to take the 6th Invitational slot.
All right, so right off the bat, we have a Glass ban. That makes a lot of sense on Coastline, no matter what, no matter who you're playing against, really. And Space Station actually going to take out the Montane. That seems like a counter ban, specifically something that I'm sure Space Station doesn't want to deal with.
Penta were using it quite a bit yesterday, more so on Clubhouse, though.
Yeah.
Didn't really see it used in some of the later maps, so maybe they're thinking that they're going to try and bring it into the fold for this one. But yeah, definitely more of a targeted ban that we'll see there. Mira, of course, is going to be a little bit more straightforward, just limits the defensive playstyle, especially on areas such as the penthouse / theater site. And then, again, another fairly standard one as the second ban, as we're going to see Maestro brought up, so we won't have that double threat combo potential of Maestro and Echo to really annoy some of these attacking teams. More importantly, limit the potential for some late round executes.
So, operate selection already coming out. He's got a lot of 3 speeds going on. SSG, being a little bit heavier on that fragger side of things, but still a good split on the utility. IQ, a very powerful operator on this map in particular. And since Valkyrie is still in play, you generally want to have her brought. Though, curiously, we are not going to see a Valkyrie from Penta, despite how useful she is on Coastline as a map. We do see Echo, though, making it through the ban phase. As you can see, it was the Maestro who was banned out instead by Penta. That makes a ton of sense. We've talked many times about how proficient Redeemer is with that LMG on the Maestro. And we've often critiqued teams for not banning Maestro against Space Station. So finally, somebody catching on to it. Penta, I think, great decision making there.
Of course, you guys can see we're going to the blue bars first to start things off. The setup phase will be concluding in just a moment here. In terms of Penta's setup themselves here, we could see quite a bit of roaming potential. And that would align pretty well with what they were trying to do yesterday versus Chaos. That was oftentimes the crown jewel of their defensive setups, was the capability to cut down Chaos early on in the round before they could even really get into the building, let alone get close to any of the sites. And if they're able to repeat that here against Space Station, of course, they'll be able to limit that potential very much the same way. Space Station out on the board, though, so let's take a look at how they're going to approach this attack.
All right, overall, the setup is finished. The double bar, again, one of those bomb sites you can bring as your first, but isn't common. You can see that it's going to be a heavy emphasis on the horizontal roam from Penta. Got Ravon in that main lobby, just looking to distract and delay as long as possible. And that's going to be a big part of how Coastline plays out in the end. Jala, though, just putting some pressure early on to the side entrance, and Bosco gonna sneak his way in through delivery. Thinking Nate as well, just in front. This could be an explosive entry into the site if Space Station play it right. You can see they're droning out before they commit to this. Nate can open the wall or the door, and Bosco gonna run through and get the entry frag onto Sir Boss. Great coordination, and on top of that, they've pushed into default plant at the same time. This is beautifully played and executed from Space Station. Rampy and Chala gonna get a kill of their own, one with a Claymore, and it's just Ravon alone in a 1v5. He'll even it down to 1-on-4, but he will be finished off by Chala. A beautiful play by Space Station. Gotta say, excellent coordination there.
Yeah, this is where, unfortunately, the defensive strategy for Penta can really come back to bite them. I mentioned how they're going to be having a lot of emphasis on their roaming capability, and that was true in that round. Not a whole lot of players on site, so what does Space Station do? They walk right in. Obviously, the castle barricades are going to be no problem with the sledge on the attacking side, so they're able to get past that with no issue whatsoever. They brought plenty of soft destruction, as you can see there. And yeah, made it a very easy job. Penta really didn't even know what hit them, and allows for a very easy opening round on Space Station.
I gotta say, overall, the coordination, again, it feels like I'm repeating myself here, but it was next level from Space Station. Something we don't really see from them specifically. Like, this is the sort of thing you expect to see from teams like G2, you know, Evil Geniuses, Rogue, you know, the top dogs of their region. And I think that's what Space Station are so close to proving themselves to be. Of course, they're going to have to win here and go on to play G2 to prove that. And it's not even close to being done yet. So nice execution there from Space Station, reading the opportunity. Penta, they definitely need to shore up their hold. I don't like that they relied on a castle barricade. You saw that placing it on the kitchen doorway, okay, yes, you're gonna get a little bit more of a prompt before you start seeing action, but the way that Space Station got past that hurdle was sledgehammer, then Ash immediately runs through. There's not enough time for Penta to react. What's the solution to that? Penta, put a roamer in kitchen or by delivery.
We'll see if they try to adjust for that once again as we get further into this round, or if we go back to that site, first of all. We have changed things up a little bit going into the second round. Once more, Space Station are out onto the board now, so we'll see the attacking route they'll take. More than likely, if they do the same as last round, we should see them head in from the east side, either towards the main entrance or the service entry. And that looks like it's going to be the case once again here, as we see them moving in a very similar fashion. But as you were mentioning, there's that lurk coming out now from Penta. They are going to establish a much more active presence towards the kitchen and service entrance areas this time.
Yeah, good job from Panic seeing the hole and trying to fill it up. Of course, as you talked about, different site. So the one big difference here is if Space Station choose to clear downstairs first, then they're going to have to work their way up, which is going to take some time.
It's just slow droning here at the start from Space Station as they do allow their players to clear them, but they also are moving a few players in through the first floor now. And that is going to be, think, starting things off here for Space Station. All closely behind by Bosco. The two of them working together relatively quickly, of course supported by the drone to give them the intel they need to clear out this map and into them closer and closer to the site. Not really a whole lot of combat happening just yet. The lurkers from Penta seem to have been immediately pulled back and are played, if not on the site, much closer to the site.
I love that you call them lurkers. It's that Counter-Strike flavor seeping through.
Yeah, a little bit.
It's good. I like it. It adds a little bit of texture. Yeah. We're not used to calling them that. Ravon gonna eat some damage early on, and he'll be taken down to about 20 HP. That's not a good start for him. Obviously, probably thanks to Chala using his IQ gadget to detect Ravon, likely using his cardiac sensor and figure out he can, maybe do some damage through the window.
They'll group up and they'll continue to hold the lobby site for now. More being held over here towards security with Panics taking control there. Besides that, it's going to continue a very slow-played affair here for Space Station. A lot of time gone by, though, and not a lot of progress made, at least not as much as before. They're only just now getting drone access towards the actual sites to allow them in, and the IQ, of course, is trying to figure out as much as possible what's gone. But there's a well-placed C4 from below. Revan destroys two and absolutely stunts this attacking force from Space Station now.
Beautifully done there from Ravon, and stunts is the perfect word as Lake's going to be gone for Space Station. They've lost a lot of manpower, and it's going to be hard to recover this, especially considering enemy will put another kill on the board, taking down Redeemer. It's all up to Thinking Nate and Bosco. And they are known to frag, but not so in this round. A perfect one for Penta. And we will go to 1-1.
Two rounds with two very different flavors, if you look at the way that they end up playing out. Space Station walking right in the first round and not even getting close in the second due to the nice denial from down below, and obviously Space Station not being able to adjust quickly enough with their remaining three.
I mean, it's really hard after you lose those initial two in such an explosion. I mean, something ticks off in your mind. You go, this round's done.
Yep.
We lost two for free, basically, and yeah, it's... We skipped a step, and that step was clearing out the roamers downstairs. You know, they had the tools. SSG had the tools to clear out C4 from below. They had an IQ in play. So it definitely is something they could have done. It's just something they decided not to do, and it cost them. Hopefully, they're going to correct that moving forward.
Well, we will move down to another site this time around here. Obviously, with Penta taking control, they choose not to go back to the double bars, and instead, we're going to head over to the kitchen instead, where Space Station were able to walk right in the first round before. So obviously much more active defense going to be here this time. And we'll see how well Penta are able to hold it.
Yeah. You know, one thing I do really like about this match already is that we've seen two very one-sided rounds, as you stated, different flavors. And the mistakes that are being made are not from any one team in particular. And this really reinforces what we were theorizing at the beginning of the match, before the match actually, that this is going to be a very close match throughout. And as we go to, I'm sure, the full distance, but, 5 seconds remaining. Can only be so excited. Let's actually see what the action will tell us as Space Station have brought a good kit to attack this bomb site. You can see they got the Ying Candelas and the smokes from Rampy. So all the tools you need to execute properly through delivery. But again, this is one of those sites that does rely on the vertical play. You need to clear out the roamers above before you start pushing the site. Otherwise, it's going to be very difficult to plant that diffuser.
So, as we see Space Station starting to move in, it's looking like they're still going to try to put pressure over here towards possibly service entrance, or of course maybe go up to the second floor first off to get themselves in from there. But you can tell, they've got a large group. They'll start droning in to see what the defenses look like. It's hungry, though, to find a nice first kill through the doorway at service. Knocking out Bosco early on. potentially a very heavy fragger that's gone early, as well as the smoke denial, of course, coming in just in the event Space Station wanted to try and quickly trade that out. He'll even throw a second smoke to the inside, as now we've got the Ying grenades coming in. Space Station finding quick trades on their own regard to knock out two from Penta. The Jaeger Sir Boss being pushed away, but thankfully Hungry downstairs, still alive, it's still holding them away, but no, Sir Boss will fall directly onto a Claymore and eliminate himself.
Hungry gonna answer the phone, very dangerous, but he's got the full cover from the bomb. Still tons of time for Space Station, and they're gonna take out Ravon as well, so it's just Hungry who got the first kill in the round. He will now have to get the last three if he wants to win out. But Space Station, plenty of time and plenty of utility. They're gonna start using those drones and calling out Hungry's exact position, but what a clean shot from the smoke. They'll decapitate Chala and even this out somewhat. Space Station know that they're in dangerous waters now. This could easily go the way of Penta if Hungry plays it right.
And Hungry nearly even rotating himself into a second kill position over there by the service door. There was someone from Space Station that was potentially looking at a peek, decided against it at the last second, and that very well might have kept that player from Space Station alive, as Hungry was very much ready to take the fight at door.
So this proximity is going to favor Hungry, but he looks away at the wrong moment. An excellent flick, but it's not enough. Sinking nade, the refrag, and Space Station take the round.
Comes down to the wire once again. So once more, a very differently played out round. We continue to be surprised just how different these rounds go. Two very one-sided ones, and one that goes the distance all the way down to a 1v1 at the end of it. And it's looking like we're gonna go back to the bars this time. So hopefully Penta feeling a little bit more confident about their play here to tie this game up at 2-2.
Hungry definitely wanted that last round. He put in a lot of work for it, but he was getting the first kill and the last couple for his team. And you notice there's two people who have zero kills right now on Penta. That's not good three rounds in. If there was just one kill difference, maybe we would have seen that go the way of Penta. But I guess that's just how it falls in the end, and it's not exactly uncommon to see that. Now, attackers still early on, we're going to go to the double bar once more. We've been here before. Last time we came here, Space Station won the round. But the way they won the round was off of a very specific strategy, and one that if your opponent knows you're attempting to execute, is usually not going to see success. Space Station worked their way into Kitchen. They had no contention throughout that clear. Once they were in Kitchen, there was a castle barricade separating the kitchen door and the hallway that leads directly into B. Sledge stacked up on it. Ash was ready to run through immediately after he broke it. And then it was a nice, easy clear for Bosco to allow for a push in through side entrance and a plant at default spot on the couches in B. Now, I'm sure Penta's aware of how that strategy played out last time, so it's not going to work for Space Station this time in all likelihood. The question then becomes, how is Space Station going to attack this? Are they gonna go something a little bit more standard? I think that's likely, probably still a side entrance push. So you can see just up there to the northwest, that's where they're gonna be spawning. They're not gonna have the advantage of surprise anymore.
It's looking like at the very minimum, Badoki might wanna play around a little bit with the upstairs entry point and maybe try to play with access to her here towards Hookah or something like that if they are able to get it. But that's what the castle's gonna be playing, so it won't be the easiest thing in the world to get anyone inside of here. Obviously, drones will still be the key in getting through this. One of the Ash Charges will be used to break down the castle barricade sitting at the entrance to Hookah. And as a result, Panic's actually back out of the room a little bit. He has, of course, this little hole to get himself back inside. He's trying his best to deny the drone intel right now and play this as best he can.
Now, it's worth noting that there is no Sledge on Space Station any longer. They've instead decided to bring the Buck, which means the castle barricades are quite a lot more powerful now. Ash can still open them up, of course, and you can use those grenades, but at the same time, it's not nearly as efficient, and is a lot of utility loss when used. Thingy Nade gets the first kill. Enemy goes down. That's one of the roamers who is playing by the small bar near Billiards. And the castle of Panix is forced back downstairs. So here we go. You talked about it. The top floor clear for Space Station, ruthlessly efficient, and they still have half the round to work with after getting full control.
Bosco's gonna be able to get the spot here on a moment, and will end up forcing back the mute further towards the actual stairway. Ends up, I think, taking out one of the Yokai drones in the process there too, so it's gonna be a pretty quick pick for him. Ravon, in the meanwhile, also is trying to deny, but the drones continue to push him out from his current position, down the main stairways and into the lobby now. So second floor, at this point, I believe, has been pretty much cleared out. Space Station have full control, and that means they can start to do some redecorating and see if it'll allow them easier access to these bars.
Yeah, so Buck is the perfect operator for this job. Fledge could also fulfill the role. Either one, really, no complaints, I'm sure. He's out of ammo, though. Skeleton T completely used up. Vaughn's going to take down Chala, and this vertical presence hasn't really given anything to Space Station just yet. Hungry trying to fight back through the bars, and he's going to take down Thinking Nades, the Buck himself. Unfortunate there for Space Station. Those holes being opened up actually working against them. That is not what you want to see as an attacking team.
And even worse here for Space Station, time is now completely gone. They need to get themselves into this site soon, but they don't have a good way to initiate since this broken ceiling has really failed to account for anything for them at this point. The site's just a few lost players, in all honesty. We're now down to the 3v4 with basically no time left. Panix is continuing to hold inside of the blue bar as well as he picks off Rampy from just inside of the window. More players are going to try to make a play here. Bosco at least picking up one for his own, but they don't have enough time to get to the site. Trades continue to come out while Bosco does find two. It won't matter. Penta successfully hold the bars, picking up the next round and tying this game up at 2-2.
Constant back and forth, and Panix really the hero of that round. He managed to retreat off the top floor, come down, and then get quite a lot of kills. If I'm not mistaken, at least the three, possibly the four. Overall, an excellent round for him. And this is as back and forth as we expected it to be. The strategy there for Space Station was ultimately their downfall. You predicted it, and you were right. They tried to clear the top floor and use that to their advantage. But guess what? It didn't work to Space Station's advantage. As soon as they had the control, it in fact ended up costing them Thinking Nade, which is not what you want to see out of an attack.
Well, we are going to head back up to the second floor now and try the Hook and Billiards room for the defensive side. See if Penta has luck holding this one to take the advantage and at least guarantee a tie at 3-3 before we end up switching sides in the sixth round.
So Billiards, we've seen once before. It was Penta who managed to take this round last time they were here. And a lot of it came down to Space Station. Again, their strategy a little bit lackluster, but it was the C4 from below that got the double kill in Aquarium. That's what really cost Space Station. And yet, again, that comes down to strategy. Clear out below before you start pushing that top floor. Kind of important, especially when Pulse has been in play most of these rounds. So, again, the IQ is in play for Space Station. They have the right tools to deal with the Pulse. Question is, will they take the initiative to do just that?
Now, Space Station are on the field, so let's take a look at how they're going to approach this. This will go for a similar route by moving in either through main lobby or the windows just outside of the penthouse, trying to get them access. Obviously, if they go for penthouse, you can see Panix will be in their way there. We'll be trying his best to stop them.
These roamers force Penta have been doing great work so far in this match. It's been a lot of the reason Penta has won the two rounds that they've won has to do with the roamers. The last one, of course, was mostly just because, again, Space Station got a little bit deflated as soon as they had the top four control. But the other round that managed to take, again, it's roamers. And the anchors have been putting in work as well, but it's definitely been the Pulse has been the star of the show so far, especially when defending the top floor. Now, you can see that Space Station are going to start clearing out from the northeast corner. But the thing to note here is that they're clearing out the top floor again. Leaving Ravon downstairs. You can see he's playing by Sunrise Bar and Panix as well in the main lobby. Panix will be droned out, so his position known. But the question is, will Space Station try to contest his position, or will they simply leave him to do damage on the flank?
Hungry still doing some reconstruction of his own from inside of the sites to wait for the impending push from Space Station, which, as we saw in the last turn, is more than likely going to be working its way down the hallways from the other end of the building, since they've now taken control of the penthouse and can work from there. Most importantly, also pushing the Jaeger back down into the lobby. And we'll see if he decides to try anything else by pushing up further later on in the round. Once again, though, Space Station very slow to start moving themselves into kind of dangerous positions against Penta here. We're almost halfway, we're a little over halfway through the round, in fact. Space Station has yet to really make any significant impact besides that control they got towards Penthouse.
Yeah, absolutely right. It's been very slow from Space Station. Not what you want to see, especially not on coastline of all maps. But they will get the first kill. And as Panix goes down, Thinking Nade traded half of his HP or thereabouts for the kill, but it was definitely worth it. The Jaeger gone means that the roamers downstairs have less of a presence, which is going to make Rampy's job downstairs a lot easier. As you can see, he's trying to hold down underneath his teammates so the C4 cannot happen from below. That's not going to be too much of a deterrent, though, for any anti-plant from the site itself. As you can see, see there's still an Echo in play, which means there's very likely Yokais. And that C4 will miss. That is unfortunate for Penta. They've still got the gas canisters and possibly Yokais in play. We don't know, though, as there's no heads-up display for that. The IQ is going to be hunting them, of course, and he will also be hunting enemy. Chala with the kill on the entry, and another one for him. And in the hallway, Redeemer takes down one. Downstairs, Rampy will eliminate Ravon, and it's a sweep-up for SSG.
Don't think a single player going down for them over the course of that round. Excellent play from Space Station and Penta. Every duel they took from the outside of the site. Some even seemed a little bit aggressive as we got into the late round there. I think they were hoping they might have been able to catch them in a push, but most of the time that didn't end up happening. Space Station shut down Penta's defense and get right back into the lead now at 3-2.
That was a pretty dominant round, but we've been seeing a lot of those, honestly. Like, I think the main takeaway from the match so far is that most of these rounds that have been won quite one-sided. And at the same time, we're at 3-2, so you can expect Penta to continue the trend and bounce themselves back here, bring this out to 3-3 to end the half as they go to Kitchen. Now, they have not defended Kitchen successfully yet, though, honestly, that trend, or the site trend, doesn't seem to be anything real or tangible so far throughout this match. For example, that was Space Station, just won on Billiards. They lost last time they went to Billiards, so there is no consistency to the sites themselves. It was the same thing with the Double Bar Space Station. Won the first time they went to Double Bar, lost the second time they went to Double Bar. So maybe this is going to be... Actually, yes, if that trend continues, then this will be Penta evening out on the 3-3, because last time Penta went here, they lost it.
And if you remember correctly as well, this was the round where Hungry nearly clutched 1v3,
yeah.
Had himself a really good position inside of Kitchen, and was able to lean himself into at least two of those three kills. Thankfully, the immediate trade came in for the last player on the Space Station. Penta's last player, Hungry, just not able to adjust in time. So they did close that up, but it was a very, very close affair and did come down to the wire. The overall execute from the guys on Space Station was successful, though. So if they are able to emulate that once again, it'll be good prospects for them to close this round out and have a 4-2 lead at halftime.
One thing I noticed here, again, Space Station starting on the northeast corner. They've been clearing from the northeast corner pretty much every single one of these rounds, it feels like. Whether they go upstairs or downstairs is really beside the point. That's where they start. That's where they begin their clear. And it all is to do with that bathroom drop down. Get into the building nice and easy there. And I guess, so, you know, start wading into the actual defense. And speaking of, that defense will be pretty established on the northeast corner. The reason being, of course, this is above the actual bomb site, and it's a great position to deny a defuse plant just inside of delivery. So Boss, so close to danger here, but he's got a great angle to deny a push in through Trophy or Guitar Hallway.
And he hasn't been pushed out of here when he's played it in the past, but this time, I don't know if the drone gets the spawn on him, but it's looking like he wants to stay around. It looks like he wants to take the fight. They've seen it, though, from the drone.
Yeah.
That's going to be indicated by that spam. So he's going to have to relocate at least a little bit. But like I said, he wants to stay here. Nade's going to force him around the corner. He's able to avoid it, but the phone call will come in, giving him away even further. Still, though, Space Station not able to find the impact necessary just yet, despite trying to take all these duels. In fact, they come out of the losing end of a majority of it. Sir Boss, thankfully, still sits at low HP, so they found impact there. But the same can be said for a lot of Space Station's players. It's just bullets randomly connecting back and forth right now with no real impact being made.
This is great teamwork between enemy and Sir Boss, but it will finally be shut down, if I'm thinking, Nade, who is really good at grenades. I don't know if his name was a deliberate pun on his part or if it just happens to be he's excellent at nades, but we've been seeing him hit a lot of those throwables throughout this tournament.
And so with that kill, finally we do see the impact made by Space Station. But as support, two players taking a lot of damage. But Buck and the IQ can be at around 50 HP to play this off. And two kills are found, not against either of those low players either, by Penta. This is certainly stunning Space Station once again. Another kill, now four picked up as enemy finds two on his own regard here. Chala and Thinking Nade both out. And it's all down to the Ash played by Bosco. He'll get stunned in the hallway. And Panics will close things out, giving another round over to Penta and keeping us nice and even at halftime, 3-3.
This has been completely back and forth. Neither team able to win two rounds in a row so far. And we will transition to Space Station's defensive half now after a very even first half for Penta on the holds. Now, Space Station are gonna have to show us something different, of course, as the coastline is usually a very one-sided map. Now, conventional wisdom states that it is an attacker-sided map, but we've seen it often actually lean the opposite direction. But one thing that is common on this map is it being either attacker or defender, depending on which teams are playing it. And We haven't seen that, obviously, given the scoreline, yet in this match. I do question if we're going to start seeing it now going into the second half, though, because Penta are now the ones who get to set the pace. And that is incredibly powerful, especially on this map, considering how shallow it is.
Penta also, generally speaking, had a much stronger attack side over the course of this tournament for the games that we've had on stream. If you look at the Chaos match yesterday, that was definitely true, at least for the first two maps. It was really the case for both Penta and Chaos. Both teams were really struggling on the defensive side. So if that's going to hold true, Penta should really be able to turn up the heat here a little bit against Space Station and maybe jet away with an early lead if their first couple of rounds are successful.
10 seconds to insertion.
I think it's possible. Double bar here to start things off from Space Station. Such a popular site these days. You know, it's interesting how the site selection goes in Coastline. It's a roundabout sort of thing. It's like sometimes you like to go to Kitchen, sometimes you like to go to Penthouse. I mean, it started with Penthouse, then it was Kitchen. Now it seems to be Double Bar. For a while we had Hookah in there. It just goes in full circle and back and forth. It's just kind of like the waves of the meta dictating that. Now, so far, looks like it's going to be a south clear, which is pretty common, especially on a double bar defense. You clear starting from Aquarium all the way into Hookah. Now, interesting thing here is that Space Station doesn't actually have any roamers above the site. So as you can see, Penta are droning that out right now. They will make that determination. You're going to see Rampy just by luggage hallway. And very likely what we'll see is they'll take control of Aquarium early on, push into Hookah, get that control, and then it'll be a pretty easy hold. They're also going to be pushing into South Office, and they're going to be meeting the Yokai drones. This is dangerous to be so aggressive with the Yokai drone when there's an IQ in play.
Absolutely, as that could easily be taken down. Thankfully, there's not a whole lot of active attack being taken out right now, there's not a whole lot of active attack being taken out by Penta at this point. Thankfully, they are able to still hold in a good position as a result of that. Meanwhile, on Penta's side, one of their lifelines was used. Try and push them towards the inside of the site.
Attackers recover
continue
the
to see. If Space Station will have good luck in holding this now, despite the complete lack of any lurking presence upstairs up to this point.
The patience from Penta could be a good thing, could be a virtue. It could also just be, it could be to their detriment, to be honest. I mean, they're taking this very, very slow, and they have the control that they need, but they know that there is no one roaming above the site.
Yeah.
That is an opportunity that they just need to seize and be done with. In the main lobby, though, looks like that's Habana enemy, possibly, doing some damage. Well, attempting to, anyway, but onto Rampy. He's going to miss all of his shots. Meanwhile, by the site, you see Ravon setting up for a nade, and there are no players playing in Sandwich right now where he's attempting to nade, so it's going to be a push from Penta and an attempted 5v5 defuse plant. The gas canisters will deny it, though. Enemy takes down Shala. The smokes from Hungry providing great cover, as well as his bullets. But Rampy will eliminate Sir Boss, thinking nade with a gas canister kill, and Bosco onto Enemy. A complete collapse from Space Station, leaving just Ravon and Panix, who are not in a good position to recover this round.
Not really in a great position to play off of whatsoever.
Yeah.
Remaining lifelines are going to be used to try and clear out over here for the courtyard since Ravon still has eyes on this. Ping's even coming in there as well. They've taken one down. They know it's not recoverable. Look at this. Nicely done by Panix. He jumps down from the upstairs. Spot is going to be able to knock out two. Rampy will move in, finding the trade. However, now down to a 2v1. Time also getting incredibly low.
I believe it's actually a 1v1. We might have the Echo, yes, down on the floor. So it's just Rampy versus Panix. But Rampy has the advantage of HP. He's going to miss all of his shots. Every single bullet going astray. But finally, Rampy finds Panix and Space Station take the round.
The one that matters connects at the end of the day, and that's what we need to see for them to shut that down as they are able to take control of it, pushing ahead early on in this opening half.
So, pretty good start here for Space Station, and honestly, it makes sense that Penta is taking their time out here right now. It really does. I mean, that I feel like should have been their round. After that attempted comeback, Panix doing so much work, downing the Echo, getting two kills there from open area, and Rampy just perfect position in that south office to down the diffuser and hold it. He knew he didn't need to push anything. He waited for his opponent to come to him, and he managed to clutch out the round. But I don't think that this is going to be a takeaway. I don't think, at this point, I'm not seeing Space Station just breaking away with the match, especially considering Penta calling their timeout right here is perfect timing.
Yeah.
They definitely seem to need the momentum back in their corner. And hopefully for their sake, they'll be able to continue that trend of back and forth rounds.
And you can see the coach having decent input to see exactly how Penta need to correct those mistakes after a very aggressive attempt at a plant there, which unfortunately ended up going their way because of the open holes along with the still active smoke presence that was going to be all across the site there. Denied their first attempt by the time they went for the second attempt. Defenders already had positions out in the courtyard and were able to pretty quickly shut that down due to the reconstruction that was done at the beginning of the round, of course.
So, looks like we're going to be having the timeout finish up finally. Penta have made all the preparation that is necessary to get themselves ready for this next round. And it's very likely what we're gonna see is a predetermined strategy, something fully fleshed out from Penta, like what we saw from Space Station in the first round, when they cleared in through Kitchen and just straight injected Defender, themselves into the site. I wanna see that again. I really don't care who it's from. It's just beautiful siege play, makes me happy.
And it was quite effective at that as well. Led to a very, very quick first round for Space Station at the beginning of this round. It's been some time since that, though.
Yes.
We've only seen one or two more of those very one-sided rounds from Space Station. Penta, of course, have had their own share of them, mainly due to a lot of good denials on their defensive side. But now they've fallen behind once again as they start off their attacking in at a 3-4 deficit. Thankfully, though, still only one round, so plenty of time to work their way back into it. Space Station is still three rounds away from closing out the map.
You know, I will say, we were talking about how Penta's had, you know, in this tournament so far, more luck on attack, and that's fair, but that last round, I mean, the way that they attacked that, they took control of just Aquarium in South Office, and they held it for more than half of the round, and it was about 120 seconds that they spent just waiting, you know, and they easily could have gotten so much more out of that time, but because they were so patient, which is just a weird thing to say, it worked against them. And I don't want to see that. I need to see them get a little bit more aggressive and try to seize the control that is available to them when that opportunity is presented. It wasn't even a trap. You know, sometimes when teams leave all that open, they don't roam above, it's because they want to C4 from below, but it clearly was not how Space Station were trying to play it. This time they do have the pulse, though, so definitely going to be an option for them here. But they're defending the top floor, so it's going to be less the anchors onto the roamers, or roam clear, and more the roamers onto the site push.
And we're going to have to wait until we see Rampy move downstairs, because right now he's actually holding pretty close to the site, so not that usual position we would see the C4 deployed from. As previously we saw it down in the office, that it was thrown down by the far inside of Aquarium, and really just destroyed the attack from Space Station.
But at the same time, you can see Serbas right underneath with the IQ right now. He's actually destroying ADSs and mute jammers using his IQ gadget from below. So it already, Space Station doesn't have the option of playing underneath. That was very, very quick from Penta. And that's the ruthless efficiency that I really wanted to see from them last round. I'm glad it's coming out here.
IQ getting the spot is gonna try to knock out some of this utility from down below. Obviously the metal bars will be a little bit annoying. Ooh, actually are gonna get the spot onto the pulse as well for a moment, as he did have the heartbeat sensor out at the time. Ravon actually nearly clearing himself an opportunity for a kill, but no, it's going to be Chala that's found out in the main lobby and knocked out early by Panix as he pushes in. He'll take a lot of damage from that, down to just below half HP, but still, a kill will still net into the advantage early on here.
That is unfortunate for Chala. Hungry going to reset himself, and Boss will be the good teammate to pick him up. Oh, cautious of the runout. Maybe Space Station knows about this, but no. There's plenty of cover from Penta. Ravon there on that north balcony watching for it. Redeemer is going to take down enemy, proving that he is just as proficient on Echo as he is on Maestro in terms of just pure fragging power.
Still going to continue to see the slow walk-ins here now, as the guys on Penta will at least take control of the majority of the first floor and have access to the bar. Again, Rampy not too keen on playing away from this and playing downstairs, thankfully. Opponents choose to take that route, so he probably would have found himself a dead man by that point if he decided to go down. Smoke going to be deploying out a lot of the gas grenades now to hold back the push. This time is so low. There is a kill coming from Ravon, though, to knock out the pulse. A second one found by Hungry to take down Bosco, two of your most influential players going down. Ravon with another one as he moves with the cool vibe steps. He's going to be able to knock out Thinking Nade, and it's all just down to the Echo. Redeemer in a 1v4. Diffuser has been planted. It's nigh impossible and will now be just that impossible as he's taken down by Panix, and we do see Penta trading back that first lost round and tying us up again.
1, 2, 3, 4, but none of them in a row for both teams, back and forth constantly. It's about as close as it can get. It is something very uncommon to see, though, in Siege. Usually this does not happen. I mean, it's going to be four in a row on one half, and then when the half switches, it'll be four in a row for the other team. And that is usually how a close match plays out. What we're seeing here from Space Station and Penta is very abnormal, but I love seeing it. Hookah and Billiards once more. Now, this is a ballsy move from Space Station. This is actually the first time we're going to see two of the same site in a row. These teams do not repeat their sites. Penta didn't, at least. Clearly, Space Station will. I'm not really sure I'm behind this decision-making. It might upset the trend, and if it does, it'll do it in the worst way possible for Space Station, that it'll put Penta ahead 5-4, and they will be first team to get two rounds in a row. But Space Station, hopefully, for their sake, have learned from their mistakes in the previous round.
Taking a page of Empire's playbook. Just play 5 rounds of aviation in a row.
I honestly couldn't stop laughing when they picked it for the fifth time. I saw it, I was like, no. Well, the fourth time I got a little bit of a chuckle. The fifth time I was like, what are you guys doing? Oh man, it was pretty weird to see that happen. And it didn't work. I mean, it did in the end.
They got it the fifth time.
They got it the fifth time, so. Woohoo!
They just really wanted to practice that stuff.
All right, well, Space Station, hopefully for their sake, that's not going to be what happens. They don't have enough rounds to do. Actually, no, they could do 5 in a row. If they do every single one, if they lose all of these, they could do 5 in a row. Anyway,
see what I'm saying?
Hopefully that doesn't happen. Hungary trying to clear, looks like, from the main lobby by himself. He is, of course, Jackal, so he's the perfect operator to do just that. As he enters his way in using the drone, he's got some good control already. There's nobody actually playing by there for Space Station. Rampy will use his heartbeat detector to actually spot him out, though. As you can see, Hungary's position now known, and that will be called to the rest of Space Station, though probably not going to matter too much in the immediate.
Slow play for Penta regardless, as Ravon is able to at least move in and take control. Still has to clear things out, of course, over here towards the blue bar. Of course, it's safe to completely move in, but reconstruction will continue as he knocks down the wall. This goes for a bit of pre-fire, as at the moment he doesn't have any drone support to check for him, so he's kind of all on his lonesome to move in here. Control, he'll do that. It's a bait. Seems to have some intel on something, but there is nothing up there from his opponent's side, so we'll just be using more of the skeleton key shots for not really a whole lot.
At least he manages to deal with one possible position. But there are some spots that the defenders are actually using quite a lot more, and more efficient drone play from Penta could make that determination, allowing for some kills from below if you just have a little bit more teamwork on Penta's side. But as we've talked about before, it seems whenever Penta are clearing from the south, they tend to take it a little too slow, and we're seeing that once again, as they've managed to take South Office and Aquarium, but just about nothing else.
Just below the 1 minute mark here too, so Penta are gonna find themselves a little bit more stressed here over the next few moments, but it's Bosco on the defense that picks up the opening kill on the Jaeger looking downstairs. Kill down the hall, and also move in. I think he's got another player down here as well. Yep, there's an easy pickup. He had a teammate moving in to try and go for the res, but it won't work. Sir Boss will be able to find. Oh. Whoa, what is that? 4 kills out of absolutely nowhere from Penta as they turn this round on its heels and leave Bosco alone in a 1v3.
It all looked so good for Space Station as Bosco got 2 on the roam, but then every single anchor felled one after another within the span of about 2 seconds. The defuser will be planted. Bosco, he's definitely got that clutch potential, but his position is well known and he will be lit up by Sir Boss, doing some significant damage through that luggage hallway. Bosco trying to rotate. Looks like Ravon, though, aware of this, will position himself in a very sneaky location. He might actually be exposed, but no. He's got the feet going backwards, which means it's unlikely that Bosco's gonna see the barrel. It's gonna be an easy lockout, but no, he does see the barrel, and the pre-fire allows for a kill, but there's not much time left. Bosco's gonna have to get both these kills quite quickly if he wants to disable the defuser, and it's not gonna happen. Enemy shuts him down. Penta take the round. 2 in a row for the first time ever.
Nicely played by the guys on Penta. They are going to be able to take swift control of that. Once again, really kind of an out-of-nowhere reversal. And as we would expect after something like that, we are going to see a timeout called by Space Station Gaming. recompose themselves, most importantly, and figure out just what went wrong in that round.
I can tell you what I think went wrong. They went to billiards twice in a row. I feel like Penta were making the right decision when they were on their defensive half. They never went to the same site two rounds in a row. If they lost something, they just mix it up, bring in a new site, and keep your opponent on their toes. But not so here for Space Station. They lost billiards once and twice, and that's the, again, that's what changed for them. That's what allowed the pattern to change for the match and allowed Penta to get two in a row. If Penta had not gotten two in a row, it would have been Space Station who would have put Penta in the bad position of having to fight for overtime. But now it certainly looks like Penta are going to be the ones to do just that, as they are just one round away from match point.
Once again, this takes us to the theory once more that Penta does definitely lean a little bit more towards the attacking side in terms of where their strength is right now, at least at this event. And that has certainly held true with taking the same site twice in a row for themselves. Believe with the ticking in the background, we have now unpaused the game now and are going live once again. So let's take a look at what exactly is in store for both of our teams.
All right. Double bar for Space Station. So here we go. Lycan definitely showing his worth as he has called, hey guys, let's defend a different bomb site. I'm sure when Lycan saw billiards the second time, he was like, ah, no, this is unfortunate. You know, one of the unfortunate things about being a coach in Siege is that you aren't allowed to talk to your team unless you're in a timeout. So if you see your team making mistakes and you really want to speak up, well, you can only do it once per match. So you better choose your moment wisely. And I think that that moment that we just saw from Lycan, that was the right call. That was a perfect opportunity for a timeout, and I'm sure he got the information that we've been figuring out here over to Space Station to help them make decisions. They have only gone to two sites, though. Double bar was the first site that Space Station went to. They won it. And we've seen billiards now, twice in a row after that. Space Station lost both times there. We'll see if they are able to win their second time, though, going to the double bar now that Penta is aware of how Space Station defends this.
This is the first time that Penta have had the lead, however, and that brings further credence to the justification of the pause from Space Station's side. They know they've now lost control as their opponents for the first time have won two rounds in a row, so they want to reel this back in before it gets too far out of control and we end up potentially with like a 7-4 if Penta just runs it out from this point forward. Don't expect that, considering how back and forth the rest of the match has been, but we'll have to wait and see, of course.
All right, enemy actually using a tool from Space Station.
Oh, no. Took out the Yokai Druid, I think.
Oh, that's unfortunate efficiency there for Penta. Well, actually, fortunate for Penta, unfortunate for Space Station. Again, a note out of Space Station's book in that enemy has cleared his way into kitchen. He's not going to be using it the same way Bosco did when he was here, but he is going to be applying pressure, if nothing else, and opening up that castle barricade is huge. Oh, possibly, no, not gonna be a kill. Reinforcement in the way, and oh, actually it goes the other direction. Rampy takes down Ravon, playing on the roam from VIP. That was a long angle, had to have been through the doorway. Damn, getting caught off guard. Ravon goes down for basically for free. That's why you gotta drone out the entire top floor before you start clearing things out.
Nice early pick from Space Station, but behind you, their utility is still slightly limited, at least when it comes to the echoes. They will have to be careful that when a site push still happens, one of those drones should still be present, though. That's really all they need to deny the plant if we end up in another very low time situation, which has been a popular theme of a lot of these rounds. So we'll see how exactly Penta are able to make up for this disadvantage that's now set against them. They have great upstairs control. As you can see, a lot of soft destruction has already been done inside of the billiards room to give them better access into the bar downstairs. Unfortunately, no kills just yet. No success in finding any of the positions from Space Station and being able to fish them out.
You see the vertical pressure actually work against the attackers a lot throughout this match for both teams. Whenever they open up these holes, it usually results in attacker dying. So I'm not terribly surprised that Penta hasn't made much more from this, though they will from the blue bar. What is going on, Chala? Completely exposed to enemy, an angle that is very common. Surprised that Chala left himself so out in the open there.
Enemy seems aware of the lurk that's still potentially going to come his way too, as he knows he still has presence that's coming from the other side. It's not going to be the same player that it was before, as that was the castle. He's downstairs in the lobby right now. Penta still, however, struggling to really fish any of the hard anchors out as time is getting incredibly low, down to just about 15 seconds. Enemy finally gets some damage onto Thinking Nathan. It will be finished off by Sir Boss later on in the round there, bringing the guys in Space Station down to three, but time is incredibly low. Enemy find another pickup, as does Panix, but Bosco comes in for the trade now as the last man standing. Diffuser has been planted, and Bosco will fall very shortly after that, giving a third round in a row now over to Penta, and the biggest lead we have seen so far in this map.
Well earned from Penta, and you were right. They're better at attacking. They've had very slow early games on attack. Very patient, but when it comes to the actual site execution, they are ruthless. I will say though, that execution came at about 15 seconds, which is very little time to make it work for your team. So surprised that they managed to win that, though that mostly comes down to the poor defense setup that Space Station had. I don't think that Space Station really has a good grasp on how to defend on this map. They've also, again, they've only gone to two bomb sites, the double bar and billiards, and they only won one attempt. It was their first time going to the double bar. So hopefully we'll see something new, and yeah, indeed, it does look like we're gonna see Penthouse actually for the first time in this match.
One of the more harder lockdown sites.
Yeah.
And certainly, of course, gonna be limited without the potential for Mira because she's been banned out. We'll have to see how well Space Station are able to hold it despite that, but maybe they are trying to play a little bit more for on-site pressure. That does not seem to be the case, though, when you look at their operator lineup, as it definitely seems like they want to rely a little bit more on lurking potential, roaming potential, being able to pick up the early kills here.
They continually bring the mute. Seems to be a staple for Space Station, and I understand that. Mute's definitely very powerful, and he's actually about to be even more powerful as when the new patch comes out about that SMG-11, but... He isn't a staple for everybody. You feel like what he does is he's similar to Bandit, of course slower, but the one thing that he does better is he's better at hurting the drone economy for the attackers. So if you ever feel like as a team, you're just feeling too pressured on your roam, or if you're feeling too pressured in terms of information, Mute is great to alleviate that for defense. And that must be why Space Station is bringing them so much. Definitely has been doing work in terms of utility. We've been seeing a lot of new jammers catch drones, but Chala himself hasn't been having an amazing map so far.
Still gonna be slow starting for Penta, as we've really come to expect so far in this half. Really taking their time with their roam before they even really set foot into the building. They should be able to make impact here relatively soon, however, as we'll start trying to make some effort to at least get into the building and then work to clear out from there.
Clear from Penta has been slow, but it has been, if not efficient, that's the wrong word. Clean. They've managed to catch all of the little corners and not leave themselves too exposed. Save for a few examples. We saw Ravon when he was in Billiards. He died to, I believe, the castle. I was going to say Rampy, who was playing in VIP that one time. Which is a little bit inefficient and dirty. Roam clear. But not many other examples of Penta leaving roamers on the wild. Space Station more than happy to let the clock tick down. I know that will work to their advantage.
It's going to be Bosco as well, still holding from below, trying to deny early access. This angle that he holds gives him great vision to the inside of the bathrooms, but he'll get occupied. There's a little bit of action going on with the doorway over at service. Certainly is able to take the duel. Promise he's been droned out. They know exactly where he is. He's got spam coming in his direction here too. So he's got to be careful with the way he plays it out. His teammates upstairs are going to start to break down a little bit more of the flooring as well, just in the event that he ends up falling due to this drone. We now see the push come out on the other side of the map, inside of the kitchen itself. It's Enemy trying to make impact here. He'll quickly take out one of the default cameras, though, and start to make his way up the Cool Vibe steps. But Bosco successfully holds by service and knocks out Ravon in that attempted push.
Hungry, though, able to refrag. And oh no, a team kill! But Redeemer does manage to take down Hungry. Rampy onto Enemy, but the Diffuser has been planted. Poor use of the Yokai drone there from Redeemer. Sir Boss able to get himself outside, watching for the runout from Delivery. And there is no one there to commit to that runout on Space Station's side. Panix, meanwhile, playing as safe as he can on the north balcony. Redeemer using his Yokai drones to, well, drone. Try to call out these last two Penta players' positions, allowing for the clear. gonna see that Sir Boss will take out Rampy as he attempts to run out on the IQ. And another one for Sir Boss. This is poor play from Space Station. The last one, Redeemer, no ammunition, and Panic shuts him down. Go to the final round. Good job to Pensa, and they will take that first map 7-4. So Pensa.